So today's video, we'll be reviewing a software called Ora. And this one is an interesting one because it's designed for teams to collaborate better on their work. Now, as you can imagine, there are different types of project management softwares. So if you're in the hunt for one right now and you're curious at which one's best for you, we've got a guide below that you can download for free to really unpack that. But Ora is an interesting solution. It's sort of come out in the last 2 to 3 years and is trying to compete with the likes of ClickUp as an alternative, trying to be a lot in one application, all in one. And as you can see, they try and combine a lot of different things like tasks, timers, chat, and obviously being able to consolidate your projects and management of that. So I think the best place to start is the pricing. And as you can see here, the pricing pops up and you can get up to 10 users for free, which gives you access to pretty much everything, but has a maximum file size of 10 megabytes at the current time of filming. There is also a professional version, which is $5.99 per user per month and billed annually, that is, but there is a $10 billed monthly pricing. So obviously dramatically cheaper to go with that. And you also get additional abilities like task relationship, recurring tasks and more. There is an enterprise version that gives you pretty much everything and SSO and things like that at $30 billed monthly or $27.99 per month per year. So we're going to explore what this application does. And as you can see, it is an application that wants to help you to manage your projects. So let's go over the features. So this is my workspace and this primarily focuses on tasks, but you can also obviously turn it into projects. So in this case up here, I can add additional views. I can add a board view, table view, calendar view, and timeline view. And naturally they'll pop up here, allowing me to switch between. And they're pretty much what it says on the tin. You can see the basic use is quite good. I found that actually, I was expecting this application to be slightly less snappy in terms of the speed, but actually didn't have any problems around the speed of the application, but I will talk later about some of the elements like pros and cons that I found weren't entirely up to date. So as a team, you can switch between these different modes. And for example, here, you've got the ability to assign things, open tasks up, and you can start planning things in your system and you can begin to create a schedule and set deadlines, star them. There's actually quite a lot of information per project. You can monitor a lot of different things like project preferences, the background, who's watching the project, exporting it, and so much detail. It's quite extensive. And you can also view it in calendar mode, which is much more of like an agenda style view. And finally, there's a fifth view called timeline. Now, actually, I'm in the free mode. You've got access to all of those views, which is something that you don't typically have in a project management free version, because a lot of them are baked under the more premium editions. So that is one of the bonuses that I was to find about that. Now in the timeline view, you do get to view per team member, per project and per milestone, which is quite good. And as you can see, you can add more projects. Here's one that I added earlier, or this is the welcome one, the launch tool finder I added earlier. And you're able to open things up, add notes, write comments, and even send little video clips back to each other, which allows for that team collaboration to happen. Now, to sort of bring things back, there are a few additional abilities which are quite nice, like this timer here that I created earlier. You can track your time. For example, here's one that I did earlier. There's 50 hours tracked. And you can also allocate whether it's a billable time or non-billable time, which is very good. And you can start the timer anywhere, and it pops up in this corner here, which I found to be quite nice. So the timer modes, I was impressed with. You can also add additional estimates to it to help you monitor what your timer's doing. Now there is additional areas for discussions. You can also direct message people, and it looks like this as a way to conversate with the other person, if that's a word. And up here as well, you can see the task that you're working on right now, which is quite cool. Up in the top right-hand corner, you can also do what's called a huddle. Now a huddle is a great way to begin discussing with other people. This is also available in other applications like TaskAid and is really suitable for smaller teams. So there's updates, there's threads, and threads are a great way to start a conversation on a particular topic and available through discussions. Now this is really helpful for being able to conversate about the particular topics that you're working on as a team. So what's nice is his application has chat alongside the project management. So over here, you can manage your plans in the top left-hand corner. And as you can see, this is the premium version where you can start to link tasks up and block tasks as well as list actions, which help to set up an IFTTT integration, which helps you to plan your task. But there wasn't anything particularly in premium that blew my mind in terms of what the offering was. You can get additional members. So obviously you need to have that to go beyond the basic pricing or the basic limits. And you can start monitoring things like this. So obviously one of the things I found inside this application is there were loads of smaller features that were hidden away and loads of other features that were just scattered everywhere. So here's a good example of that. So up here, if you press Command K, you can access the command bar, which essentially brings up everything you need. These are all features that aren't available or click away, if that makes sense. You have to find these. So for example, the My Day view has to be accessed through the preferences to set them up. And you can see a outline of your day. And this also can be connected with Google Calendar integrations to see other events. For example, up here, I've got the gym up here, and I can see anything that I'm working on at the same time, filtering it down and getting daily statistics down at the bottom. So this was really nice. So My Day I found particularly useful. And also there was a calendar view, I believe it was, which gave you a bit more of an agendarized view of what your focus is, which I quite liked. You can also change this into a Kanban type board and a calendar as well. So the optionality for this was really nice. So this is just almost like a notification, if you're considering it, that you need to be able to set this one up inside of preferences. These are all switched off when you get started. So make sure some of these are set up because else you're sort of missing out on some of these features. For example, inside of this, there's even a review mode, which allow you to see items that you can review and process for later, which is again an additional feature. This view also was a nice one because it's like a calendar view for seeing your timer, which allows you to focus a bit more and have the quality that you need to focus and really drill down on the task at hand. So all in all, this application is a really interesting one. I want to talk a little bit about the pros of Ora that I found. And those were that the general abilities and customizations of each of the pages were pretty decent. And there were quite an extensive amount of them, which is a great thing to have. Being able to switch between a lot of different views, even in this time of view, was really nice. For example, even switching from all the way from an agenda view to a timesheet was really powerful. And that's something you don't get in all of the other applications I've seen. The additional thing that I liked is having chat alongside it. And some of the video features, also a welcomed addition. As you can imagine, teams want to be able to collaborate straight away. So I can see smaller teams being very beneficial for this. Now, next up, I actually found a few issues with the design of this application. I will probably have to remember which one it was, but there were several pages that felt slightly unfinished, both in the design and the function. For example, if I'm on this page here, it feels strange because the design is all over the place. For example, even text like this is a little bit off. And I also found that the white background on certain pages reflected a really strange looking background. I found it a couple of times. I don't know whether I can replicate it, but it was like the page itself needed to be in dark mode in order to work because I couldn't see any of the things. I actually had to select the text to bring it up. So if I find that, I'll try and include it in the link in description. But it was just something that I found slightly off. It was like some of the features were slightly more rushed than other ones. There's almost also too many features in this app for a user to fully understand when they get in. There's so much going on up here and so much going on around the application that isn't explained. Now, ClickUp have this problem to some extent. They have a lot of features, but the way that they present it and pull it together is so much better. So I feel like Ora has a lot of features that they've tried to stuff in this app and haven't really yet had time to explain them, onboard users, or build it together as a fully fledged experience. But saying that, ClickUp started in this way in terms of being very everything in the kitchen sink here, and it has rolled into something much more stronger overall. So this was a review of Ora. If you're interested in checking it out, you'll find it linked in the description below. And as you can imagine, you can jump over to toolfinder.co to explore lots of different tools, project management and wide ranging, as well as a guide to project management below. Thank you so much for stopping by in today's video. If you're new to the channel, please do subscribe because we'd love to have you for more. And we can help you find all the apps over on toolfinder.co. So I will see you in a future video, but cheerio for now.